Trini Girl Natural. Hello, welcome to my channel. Today I'm excited to be reviewing Alodia Hair Care. So I came across this brand on Instagram and it just seemed really cool, like in a nerdy sort of way. So the owner is a doctor and she highlights women in STEM and just people in general doing big things in science. And I was just curious to see what she'll come up with hair care. The ingredients are pretty simple, which is good. She finally came to a hair show that I was at, so it was easy to get some stuff. So I was like, yay, let me just go grab some stuff. And here we are. So let me just tell you what I got. I got this Nourish and Hydrate Deconditioning Mask. And this Nourish and Moisturize Hair Cream. And Moisturize and Define Curling Cream Gel. So basically just enough for a wash day. She did have a shampoo, but I'm a PJ, but as tempting as it would be to have the shampoos from the line when I'm trying it, I can't get myself stuck with so many shampoos. Like, I have way too many shampoos already. So I used a different shampoo and then started my Alodia wash day from a deep conditioner. Then used the hair cream as a leave-in and then used the gel. So take a look at how that went and then I'll come back with the details of my review. Take a look. So I'm starting off on freshly shampooed hair and then it's time for my deep conditioner. So I'm using the Alodia Nourish and Hydrate Deep Conditioning Mask. So it really smells great. It smells like minty bubblegum, so I love the smell. It was dense, like thick, but it was still light and fluffy and easy to spread, so I like that. I really don't like thick deep conditioners that I can't spread. So this spread really easily and I like that. I probably put a little bit too much because I didn't need as much as I usually need. So I just spread it along the top and then work it through because I have really thick hair, so that's my usual process. But maybe next time I can use a little bit less. It did take a while to work, so at first I was kind of concerned, like, is it gonna work? But after sitting for about half an hour, it did moisturize and soften my hair. So I was really happy with it after I let it sit. The slip was good too, as you can see. So this is my hair after rinsing the deep conditioner, and now it's time for my usual wash and go. So I start off with using the Alodia Nourish and Moisturize Hair Cream. So as you can see, it's a nice consistency. It's not too runny and it's not too thick. So I just again apply it all over in my big section and then work it in, like raking and smoothing to work it in. You guys have seen me do wash and go before, so my usual method. So I really like this leave-in. It gave me a lot of moisture and a lot of definition. So this is my hair after applying the leave-in. You can see the definition is on point. I'm happy with the result. And now it's time for the Moisturize and Define Curling Cream Gel. So again, I like this texture of the gel. It really defined my curls and I really like how light it was. So if you're looking for a light, fluffy but defined wash and go, I would definitely recommend this product. It does have a bit of a cast. I know some people actually like that. If I'm using it again, I'll probably put some oil over it to avoid the cast, but the definition was great and I like how light it was. This is me showing you again in the next section. This is my hair without any product on it. And I'm just going to repeat by adding the Alodia Nourish and Moisturize Hair Cream, followed by the Nourish and Define Curling Cream Gel. You can see my hair looks pretty much dry because my hair really doesn't get wet, that whole wiry texture thing. So it's kind of funny, but anyway, I just apply the leave-in and smooth and rake like I did the last time. So this is my hair after applying the product again. And again, I just love how it looks, just really light but defined. So I didn't even need to shake because the separation was great. Maybe because of how light it was, the separation was great already. But I still did my usual shake and this is my result.
Now I know how the Lodia owner gets her light and fluffy hair, basically using these products, because my hair was really light and fluffy and big and defined at the same time, so I love that. So now I guess it's just time for it to dry, and I'll see you on the other side. Bye.
Okay, so that was it. I started off with shampooing because when I'm testing a new deep conditioner, I always like to shampoo first to really test it. So when I really clarify my hair, of course I need a lot of moisture. I need a deep conditioner that can really do the job to get things back in order. I do like that it has like peppermint in the ingredients, so it really stimulates my scalp. Of course, that would be a warning for some of you. I would call it like in a kind of salsa ranking. I would give it like a medium hot in terms of how intense it was. Like it wasn't super intense, but you couldn't forget it was there either. It was definitely felt. So let me just show you the ingredients. Aloe vera juice, honey, which is kind of my minimal for my hair. There's also a little bit of protein, hydrolyzed wheat protein, which is good because I am kind of due for a protein treatment. I do love the smell. It smells like minty. I don't know if it's spearmint or something, but it smells like minty gum. My hair was definitely eating it because I had just stripped my hair, but even then I only used half, so I would say a little bit goes a fair amount. So that was good about this as well. It had a very nice, light, creamy texture. It spread easily. The slip was nice. I did have that moment of panic that I've been having with a lot of like my recent deep conditioners where I'm like, is this gonna work? Is it gonna work? But after it sat, it did moisturize and soften my hair. It definitely was light in a way because it spread easily and everything. It wasn't like really super thick, but it still didn't really penetrate. It reminded me a little bit of the Sultanica's Soul Repair Despair. You know what I'm talking about? That new one, the Vitamin Despair Hair Repair, I think. Reminded me of that somewhat in that it was a sitter. I somehow forgot to show you guys me after sitting, but I did post on Instagram, and I might just include that video in the corner or something of me after it sat and my hair felt soft and moisturized. Before it sat, it was on my hair, but not getting in there. And I could feel my strands. My cuticles are naturally kind of rough, so I could feel my strands still feeling kind of rough, and it still wasn't feeling soft and moisturized. But after sitting, it did the thing. So overall, I'm a happy camper, and it definitely did the job, and it's definitely a good product. Yeah, I'm sure this is an excellent product for somebody who doesn't have ultra low porosity hair, since it did the job eventually. So I can't even tell her to change anything. Of course, naturals could always have more slips, so that might be the only thing, but this is perfect for somebody. So one thing about this deep conditioner is that it's really thick. It was surprisingly thick, so of course nothing's going anywhere. And then even just pushing it down, it's kind of resisting a little bit to go down. So it was dense. I wouldn't say thick, but dense, because you can see it's still pretty light and fluffy, but it was just dense. And you can see, let me see if it's going in. You can see there was a slight struggle, and even now, I mean, it's worked in, but my hands, I can feel that layer on it. So after the conditioning, I sectioned my hair and started my usual wash and go. So I started with this hair cream. The slip was just a little bit below average, so that wasn't the best thing, but it definitely gave me a lot of moisture, a lot of shine, a lot of definition. So these are the ingredients. You can see they all kind of follow the similar trend. Water, fatty alcohols, aloe vera juice, honey, and essential oils. This is the consistency. It's really light. Given the ingredients, I think this did a really good job in terms of definition. I was surprised, pleasantly surprised by the definition. And my hair was also doing well in terms of shine. This one was not pepperminty. It was a little bit more herbal. So none of these are like sweet, fruity. I mean, this deep conditioner gives me slight bubble gum, but this definitely goes more into herbal. So the last one is this Moisture Defined Curling Cream Gel. These are the ingredients. Of course, it had the basic ingredients, but it also had the pectin, marshmallow root, xanthan gum, which I like to see. Marshmallow root for slip, and the pectin and xanthan gum are more natural definers. I know for xanthan gum, it's kind of debatable whether it's natural or not, but it's definitely more natural than carbomer. Unfortunately, this also has carbomer in it. And you know, I'm not a super fan of carbomer, so I was definitely cautious when I saw that. But I was like, I'm gonna give it a go anyway. Just to try more of the line and just to see if maybe it being so far down, the pectin and xanthan, which gels I like, would kind of overpower or cancel out the carb butter. That was my hope. It has coconut oil for those who don't like that. Yeah, I see coconut oil in all of them. This had better slip, probably due to the marshmallow root, but the water was kind of being sucked, which happens when I use carb butter. Like, the water was kind of being sucked out of my hair a little bit. What I like about this is this. I mean, it gave me a really cute shape, and the definition is good as well. You know, it gave me nice definition. So I did like that. And there is movement. I mean, it is stiff, surprisingly, which I guess is probably, again, the carb butter. Because when I'm using a cream gel, I don't expect it to be stiff. So I was like, okay, nice big soft hair week, and then I ended up with this crunch. So it doesn't feel dry, and the definition and shape is great. It just is a little crunchy. My hair looks, for me, the shine isn't perfect, so I know that you still see shine, but my hair naturally has shine, so if it's not blowing away, I know it didn't add any shine. I love how light it is too, so after I put it on, my hair just felt really light. It actually dried faster than pretty much any of the other stylers that I've used that I can remember, so fast drying, light, great shape, great definition. I think if you're looking for a cream gel that acts like a gel, like gives you that cast and everything, then this might be a good gel for you to try. It's a cream gel that packs a punch like a gel, so that was interesting. I would love to use this just to get the shape again, and you know, I liked it, so I'm probably gonna play around with it a little bit more. It's not super duper crunchy, it's just a little stiff. And of course the definition and hold is good, at least I know it's gonna last a week, no problems. So that was it, my first review from my hair show hauls, I believe. I know a lot of you were looking forward to seeing this review. So just let me know what you think, let me know what you're interested in buying. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to support your YouTuber. See you in the next one. Bye.